Hi guys, my name is Crystal and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you like my videos, hit the like button. Alexa, what's the time please?
It's 10:49 a.m.
Okay guys, I've just taken Max for a walk on the Rochester Riverside field. Before I did that, I rang my mother because I'm a caring daughter. I care about my mum. She told me she wasn't well yesterday. She hasn't rung me. She normally rings me early in the morning and leaves a message, and I know my mum's okay. She hadn't rung this morning. So I thought I'd give my mum a ring. She said she wasn't well yesterday. I was worried about her. She answered the phone really quickly, and she said she overslept, so she'd had a long lie-in. My mum did. And she said, would I like to go up there tomorrow? She hasn't got very much money, and could I pay one way? I've got to go and collect my prescription. I'm supposed to have been picking it up this week, but I haven't done it. And I was planning to go and pick up my prescription from Boots in Rochester tomorrow, which means walking over the Strood Bridge. Basically, I get up early now. The guy upstairs has got kids, so I tend to work myself around that. Instead of arguing the toss, I try and sleep around the times that his kids are asleep, and then I'm not so shattered when I wake up. So I went out with Max. I'd been out to the co-op. As you can see, I've got the Sun newspaper. I said I'd get the cat litter. I've gone out. This is £5 a bag, this cat litter. I was going to order it from Sainsbury's, but they've never got the cheap cat litter, so I thought I might as well go and get the cat litter. So I've been out to the co-op, Rochester, and got cat litter. Right. I've also got detergent. Now, all their capsules are out of stock. All the co-op, you know, tablets, the capsules that you put in the washing machine, mine's broken, I'm hand washing, by the way. So I got BioColour laundry liquid, which was £3.80. Bear in mind, everything has gone up, everything you can possibly imagine has gone up. So they haven't got their, you know, the little pillow things you put in the washing machine. They haven't got those. They haven't got any of those. And the cheapest thing they've got in that form is £5. So I got that for £3.80. That cat litter cost me £5, which I would have got in my shopping tomorrow, but I've got it in the co-op instead. I don't want Sainsbury's substituting my shopping with something that I don't want. So I've got the cat litter, I've got the washing detergent. And I've got something to eat for dinner. Right, so I'm going to have meatballs today. Yesterday I had a Cornish pasty with spaghetti hoops, which was very tasty. So I've got chicken meatballs in tomato sauce. I've got chips that I bought from my Sainsbury's shop 2 weeks ago. I've got fries left. I've got chunky chips. I've got sausages. I've got beef burgers. And I've still got a pizza. Right? So I'm not short of food to eat. Now this is the mentality of people, and I think it's cruel, I think it's nasty, and they think it's funny. As I was walking down Common Creek Wharf, as everyone knows, I walked down there, turned the corner, and there was a French fancy cake, not eaten, not touched, on the wall. A French fancy cake. Now, it wasn't a donut, it wasn't a tart, it was a French fancy, one of those French fancies, left on top of the wall. Walked past it, I mean, they used to do that in Gloucester as well. You know, when you haven't got much money, they used to leave, throw peaches on the floor, put food in the bin, thinking me and my kids would take it out and eat it. Food into the bin. Now, I have got enough money to live on. And even if I was short, I'd go to a food bank or a church. I certainly wouldn't eat food off the floor, or a wall, or on a bench. And I certainly wouldn't drink, you know, they're even leaving open bottles of mineral water on the floor, which is probably contaminated with shit or something. Piss. What do I know? So I walked past the French fancy cake, builders drilling down the bottom, and then a group of builders on the scaffolding. Oh, it's nice and quiet round here, isn't it? Oh, it's nice and quiet. We've had graffiti, we've had fences knocked over, there's kids screaming, there's their own builders drilling, and there's dogs barking. Quiet, is it? You need your ears rinsing out. There are builders are drilling down there. I've had to shut my windows. It's quiet. Well, perhaps it means there's not many people about. Well, perhaps they've gone on holiday. So I get onto the field, walks Max. I mean, I can't let him off the lead. There's people on the field today. A woman with a black dog, like my next door neighbour. She's got a black dog, mine's a chihuahua. And, you know, I just walked around, minding my own business, getting on, taking pictures of the riverside and the boats, which I like doing. And then I walked back, past laughing, what looked like a couple of builders sat on a bench, or refuse men, laughing. I felt a bit dizzy and faint, and then I walked back on, and past the cleaner with the white cap on. And I've got into my flat. Before I went out, my neighbour was on the balcony. And I just ignored it, which I am doing. And I don't want to talk about people that are not worth talking about, to be honest, because they like getting attention. So, guys, I've got food to eat. I've still got Belgian bun from yesterday, you know, the Belgian bun with the icing and the cherry on the top. I don't need to eat rotten food left out and to waste that attracts flies and crap. Right? You go, carry on, carry on, carrying on. I know what you all did to me in Gloucestershire, and I don't mean people watching my videos, they know who I mean. I know what was done to me, let's rephrase it. I know what was done to me in Gloucestershire. I know what happened, right? Bit like the Hillsborough disaster, a massive cover-up, right? With bogus police and all that shit. Okay, carry on, but we're not living. You know, I had kids then I was struggling to feed, and pets, right? Now I'm on my own and I've got nothing to lose, and it's not me.